Hi, I'm Nathan Zampronio, and I'm here in Canberra at the Australian Local Government Assembly, a conference that I come to once a year. After the interruptions of COVID, this conference has turned out to be the biggest ever, with good representation from many of the 537 local governments around Australia. I want to say that being a councillor is a serious business, and there's a lot to learn about the setting of Hawkesbury Council in a national setting. Councils only take in 3.5% of all taxation revenue levied across all three tiers of government, and yet local governments are responsible for 24% of all the work we do nationally to provide public assets, services, and to plan how our communities can grow and thrive. For the last 6 years, I've come to this conference to be a better local representative. I'm here with Councillor Lyons Bucket, and we wonder why none of our other colleagues ever bother to come down here to Canberra. A new federal government represents new opportunities. We heard from the two federal ministers responsible for local government, Catherine King and Christy McBain, that the local government portfolio has been restored as a cabinet ministry. It's also regained its seat at the National Cabinet, which it lost when COAG was dissolved in 2020. Compare that to last year, when we were addressed by the then Deputy Prime Minister about local government, Michael McCormack, who was full of promises and then found himself out of a job by the end of the same day. But we are here to remind the federal government that that recognition has to come with adequate resourcing. Federal grants to the local government sector used to represent over 1% of all federal taxation revenue in 1996. Now it's declined to half of that. If you're inclined to be frustrated at your council because of the potholed roads, the delayed DA approvals, or ageing community infrastructure, it's because there has been a long-term gulf that has grown between what councils are responsible for and the money that we have to do it. Economists call that vertical fiscal imbalance, but you and I would call it cost shifting. We estimate that it has taken $3.5 billion out of our sector annually. No wonder you're cranky at councils. Mind you, we also saw some figures that showed that local government is the most trusted tier of government in Australia. Like electricity, we don't reflect on the value that local government gives us from day to day. But as soon as the power's off, you're on the phone or social media straight away. One remark I heard here to challenge us was, well, you don't need a democratic institution to provide roads and pipes and footpaths. But for long-term planning and coordination, your views in the community deserve to be represented. It's our home. At this conference, I learned that electric vehicles like rubbish collection trucks, mowers, and utility vehicles are now a more economic proposition than the internal combustion engine vehicles that they replace. You don't need to be an environmentalist anymore to support their adoption. They're actually better for council's bottom line. I spoke to several providers of geospatial technologies, the kind of tools that our council should have been investing in so that they can estimate the changes to tree cover caused by the boundary clearing code. We learned that our inability to grapple with housing affordability and especially social housing has a profound effect on the equity of our communities. And we heard from analysts and experts that described the shift in the way that we estimate the impact of our policies. If a big box retailer wishing to put shops outside our town centre, well, we currently don't factor in the costs of the reduced vibrancy and viability of our historic town centres. When a developer wants to develop a greenfield site for housing, we don't factor in the hidden and ongoing costs caused by the reduction of our agricultural capacity in the Sydney Basin, which is close to its natural market. We measure things in terms of GDP, but rarely in terms of social capital or wellness. We were shown figures that Australia's investment in local government is quite small by international standards as a function of GDP. We were reminded that we're not just a service delivery arm of another tier of government, but we're a democratically mandated, effective part of our polity that understands our communities best because we're closest to them. We were honoured by a visit by the ambassador from the Ukraine to Australia, Vasyl Miroshnichenko, who gave a very moving address and gained a standing ovation from the delegates. And the last thing I learned is that e-scooters are really, really cool. This has been a fantastic way to get around Canberra. In New South Wales, our planning minister, Rob Stokes, has issued a call to councils to invite them to be part of a trial for the introduction of e-scooters, both private and commercial, and their regulation. On the basis of this experience, I'm rather inclined that Hawkesbury Council should see if we could take part. Cheerio.